The way that the project with Fortunato started was one of my bosses CC'd me an email that said goat legs, just goat legs.
I went into work one morning and there was an email that just said goat legs, and I looked at it and I'm like, okay, I guess this is just another Monday.
So goat legs was in reference to a baby goat that had lost its two hind feet. So sometimes baby goats will have infectious processes, and this one was called septic arthritis that had caused an infection in the joints, and that goat lost both of its back feet. I had previously toured the business school, and I was introduced to Studio 231. I met some of the students in there, and we had had some discussions about 3D printing models for the vet school. So knowing that they could make unique items there, we reached out thinking they might want to take on making some goat feet.
At first I was just like, how are we gonna make legs for a goat? We had no idea the condition of Fortunato. We had no idea if the legs needed to move or actually have like parts. We knew very little in the beginning. Fortunato actually came into the studio a couple days later, and we actually took our initial measurements and had a little bit of a better idea of what we were actually designing for.
We had all the faculty and people from the vet school to kind of help out with kind of our questions. Because as mechanical engineers, we aren't well versed in the anatomy of a goat. And we went through probably like 5 iterations of legs in the span of probably like 3 weeks.
And this is a baby goat, so Fortunato was going to get bigger, which meant that the prototype also had to be adjustable, which really changed the designs around a lot. We were really surprised to see he could actually almost walk on his own without any prototype. It was hurting him. He seemed like eager to walk, which is why we knew he'd take well to like a boot style prototype.
We definitely wanted to figure out exactly how to make this durable and comfortable at the same time. So we were doing some research into different materials of what we could do, both what we have here as well as what engineering has.
I think the concept they had pretty right from the beginning. We just needed to extend the back legs and give this goat something to walk on. It was just making refinements to make it work and stay in place that were really important to the project.
This was actually where we ended up after the first interview. One of the hardest things we had with designing was figuring out how to keep the boot on. So what we ended up doing was designing a softer resin sock made on the material science department's like high quality resin printers. It's a pretty much a silicone material. And we designed it to have a bunch of pores in it so that it had a good flex.
So they were able to reach out to other departments that had specific expertise, and we all collaborated together to come up with a really good solution. We've been really trying to do that as a vet school as a mission, and that was our first time getting all these different units together to actually solve the problem.
But we got a prosthetic style that we finished on that was a bit kind of like a shoelace or like a corset that you could tighten at different sections and have different thicknesses. After we got it on and he did a couple laps around the studio and pooped a couple times, we decided it might be best to move everything outside, really like play test it, because we heard that he really hasn't been outside that much. So we all ended up getting up and running to see if he'd like follow us. So we all ran away from him and he looked at us, and then after a couple seconds like ran towards us. And it was really cute. He ended up like doing like a little hop and everything. It was an amazing sight to actually see that, you know, he could run.
Anytime we consider doing a project like this, we put a lot of thought into the quality of life for the animal afterwards. We came in the first day to a back of a goat's leg drawn on the board. They had researched the anatomy. They had already come up with a couple different models that they planned to use. They were really well prepared, but I think they were also able to be creative and entrepreneurial in their approach.
To sum it all up, it's definitely nothing I could have ever expected. It makes me really happy that we were able to do something like this, and it really shows how great this space is.
I would not have imagined that I worked on something like this in a million years. It was a really good feeling to see that a prototype that I made on Fortunato and working and actually like giving him something he didn't have before is indescribable.